This place is gonna come down. My name is Dr. Pierce, lead researcher.
North Moore was director before me. I never wanted his job. I never wanted power. I purposefully avoided it, didn't trust it, didn't want to rely on it. North Moore was all about power. A man like an explosion, hungry for authority, for order, for more, until it was too much. I had to find a solution in the end, contain the situation. North Moore never liked me, but he went along with it, to his credit. He didn't really have a choice. I suppose at the end of the day, a director's most basic duty is to keep the lights on. Here's to you, North Moore. There were no prime candidates waiting in the wings, but I was there. Had been the whole time. Keeping my head down, working my ass off. I had nothing to lose. I picked up the gun almost on a dare. It took us a long time to learn how to stabilize the control points, the ley lines, the meridians of the oldest house. Darling found a way to soothe this beast.
is fried up. You need to fix it before the old twig pants inside the plant has a shit fit.
You are the best of all the times. We were just in the box, so you lost your.
lifted by a directorial override.
This is what we came here to do.
That's it. The other sector should be open now. I think it's time I told Emily why I'm here. I'll risk it. You two should get to know each other.
Thank you.
So much is expected from the director. The responsibility, the privilege to steer the Bureau into dangerous waters and safely out again. To inspire and lead its people, to protect them. The board is there to advise you, but they want things in return. You hold all this in your old, trembling hands. I had to lose everything before I could see the Bureau is the director's life. There's no room for anything else. If the forces contained here escaped, we'd be dragged back into an age of superstition, terror, death. Assuming you think we ever really left that behind. Any emergency, any major containment breach, and the lockdown goes into effect. I implemented this security measure in my first years as director. I knew we were vulnerable. I'd personally seen the cost of sloppiness. I made sure the internal lockdown could only be lifted by a directorial override, only to be used when the director is confident the sectors are safe to be opened again. This way, the director is the last line of defense. And if I screw up, it's on me, and me alone.
I heard the Hiss attack the power plant. Brings up a lot of new questions.
Jesse, you made it. And you lifted the internal lockdown.
Let's talk, Emily.
Yes, of course.
Listen, Emily. Screw it. Just tell her. I haven't been completely honest. I have a younger brother, Dylan. When we were kids, we found an old slide projector in Ordinary's landfill. The slides created doorways to other places. Bad things happened. Came through.
That's all she gets. The rest stays locked inside.
But we found help. Through one of the doorways, we met something. A being.
A being? What kind of being?
It's hard to describe, but it... She helped us. We managed to turn the projector off. The bad things that came through the doorways were gone. After that, your people came. Tried to grab us. I ran away. They got Dylan.
I left him behind.
Bureau agents took your brother?
Yes. You covered it up. No one believed me. I just want to find Dylan. I've been looking for him ever since.
What happened to the slide projector? It sounds like another object of power.
I thought you took it. The Bureau. Along with Dylan.
I've never heard of it. But around here, I assume everything's classified. You know, I looked into the ordinary AWE case files after you mentioned it. Trench and Darling were both involved. A large area of the containment sector was reserved for it. The case hasn't been active for a long time. I have no idea if anything's still there. Can you tell me more about this being you found?
Let's hope you two get along.
She's been with me ever since Ordinary. In my head. She led me to you. I call her Polaris.
As in, a guiding star. Did Polaris know about the Hiss? If she got you in here, in spite of the lockdown, she's very powerful. Which may help explain your test results. Your readings are incredible, Jesse. Now, cross-referencing them with the database, I found two matches in Darling's old classified files. Unfortunately, I can't access them beyond the file codes, but one was P6, referring to a prime candidate for a potential future Bureau director. This was logged years ago.
Dylan. Is that Dylan?
The other match is on something called Hedron, which must be connected to these Hedron Resonance amplifiers somehow. All I know is that Marshall went to the research sector to secure the HRA production after the Hiss first attacked.
So, Marshall seems like our best lead on Dylan.
I need to go after her. How can I get to the research sector?
Use my keycard. The sector elevator will take you there.
Marshall is the next step. What Emily told me about Ordinary, my powers being connected to things in the Bureau's past, I am so close to something. Do you feel it? Something's coming.
We take turns to come for a visit. I helped you. You owe me now. And when time comes, I will come calling.
Hi, Jesse.
See you soon.
Be careful out there.
Hope has asked us to document the Hiss incantation, she calls it.
You mean like in person?
heard the Hiss attack on Paladin. Brings up a lot of questions.
These readings are eradicated for the oldest house. The Hiss are tampering with it somehow, agitating it. Matching frequencies, maybe? Hi, Jesse.
I keep finding traces of Darling, but still can't find him. Where could he be?
He's usually in his office in research, or one of his labs. Dr. Darling has quite a few, all around the Bureau. Could be hiding in any one of them. I check myself, but I don't have access to most of them.
Sounds like I touched a nerve.
He didn't let you into his labs?
Not all of them, no. Some had volatile material. That's ridiculous. I mean, this whole place is volatile material. Could have at least thought of a more convincing lie. I mean, how can I work without access to all the data possible?
This place has a bad habit of moving around, huh?
So you notice the building shifts. Did you know that 39% of Bureau accidents are caused by the shifts? It's true. I ran the numbers myself.
So they're dangerous.
Oh, very. Yet one time, a shark got shifted into a meeting room along with over 2,000 gallons of water. It was a tiger shark, Darling's pet research project. I forget what he was researching.
How do people work here?
You said you're an assistant?
Oh, it's just a title. I'm a scientist, a researcher. I work for Dr. Darling. See, when Bureau agents go out in the field, the sites of altered world events, we study the materials, the altered items they bring back. It's always something we've never seen before, and studying them requires new instruments, methodologies, sometimes entirely new fields of science.
Emily really loves her job.
See, there's no guidebook for what we do here. Everything that happens at the Bureau, including the science, is without precedent.
What exactly is the Ocean View Motel?
That's a bigger question than you might think. You see, I have extreme doubts that the motel is a single place. I mean, look at all the doors inside it. Where do they all go? We know that one door leads to the oldest house, but how come we can only ever open that one door? Maybe to open a door, you have to have entered through it. So if every door leads to a different dimension, plane, reality, whatever you want to call it, then I believe that the motel is firm proof that parallel universes exist.
Does Darling agree with that?
I haven't told him yet. I'm waiting until I can prove it.
What can you tell me about control points?
They're nexus points of the oldest house's unique energies. Well, I wrote a 30-page proposal hypothesizing that we could siphon energy directly from them. Darling didn't even get through the first page before he turned it down.
Right. And, has anyone ever used them to teleport around?
What, no. What, I mean, you mean physically? No, not that I've ever heard of.
Why? Because that's how they work for me.
What? Really? Oh my god. More tests.
Let's hold off on the tests until later, okay?
Okay. It's just, wow. This blows my control point theories right out of the water. I love it.
See you soon.
Be careful out there.
Attack the power plant. Brings up a lot of new questions. Are they communicating? Coordinating? What about the plant attracted them?
The power plant is largely confidential. No use guessing what this cloud is if you don't even know what kind of energy it uses.
What do you mean?
welcome to the research sector of the Federal Bureau of Control. I'm Dr. Casper Darling, head of research. Somebody thought this video would make for great internal communications. I'm looking at you, Mr. Tomasi. So, this is where the magic happens. Anyway, I've been here for 24 years now. I've always been here. And through those years, we've made astonishing discoveries, authored studies of grave importance, and in all this work, there is one thing we know, and that's how little we truly know. Rest assured, we're committed to keep pushing the known laws and borders of reality, and to make the Bureau proud. So, welcome. Assuming you have the necessary clearance, and do follow the safety protocols. Read the manual. Otherwise, bad things will happen. Happens. Anyway, I've been here for 24 years now. I've always been here. And through those years, we've made astonishing discoveries, authored studies of great importance, and in all we know, and that's how little we truly know. Rest assured, we're committed to keep pushing the known laws and borders of reality, and to make the Bureau proud. So, welcome. Assuming you have the necessary clearance. I've been fielding questions recently regarding HRAs. What are they for? Do you always need to wear them? And what's the deal with the Hedron resonance anyway? Despite what you may have heard, HRAs are not monitoring devices. We're not tracking your movements or listening to your conversations while you're wearing them. We do that regardless whether or not you're wearing an HRA. Think of them as a life preserver. Only instead of water, the thing HRAs protect you from is classified. One day that classified not water might pour in and you'll be glad you got an HRA keeping you afloat. And if you don't have an HRA, don't worry. It'll be quick and painless. Kidding. I'm kidding. We're making more. I've been fielding questions recently regarding HRAs. What are they for? Do you always need to wear them? And what's the deal with the Hedron resonance anyway? Despite what you may have heard, HRAs are not monitoring devices. We're not tracking your movements or listening to your conversations while you're wearing them. We do that regardless whether or not you're wearing an HRA. Think of them as
I'm averse to using objects of power. I don't want to lean on things I ultimately can't trust. But the ashtray and the cigarette, smoking there forever, have their uses. The ashtray maze they conjure is an impossibly changing labyrinth that no one but the Binder, and those the Binder invites, can ever pass through. The things we hid in dimensional research, the things Darling studies, the danger and the risk involved, call for every measure of security and protection I could bring to the table. The maze, hands down, is our strongest lock. I gave Darling and his chosen crew license to pass through the maze. Lately, I've started to think I should revoke that license.
Thank you.